Dr. Sushil. Welcome to the new topic, barriers to communication. Communication means when you want to share some piece of information with or without language to somebody. See, why do we communicate? There is a solid reason behind our communication. We want to put across a message to somebody. See, what happens? Maximum times our message is not understood well by the receiver. There comes many a problem. Sometimes the problem is on the part of the speaker, sometimes the problem is on the part of the message, sometimes the problem is on the part of the medium, sometimes the problem is on the part of the receiver. See, unless we understand these, the nature, the true nature, all these problems, we can never communicate well. These things, they are needed to be understood well to do good communication. They are called, in a sense, they are called a noise. Noise means barrier. And in totality, means if we include all these noises, they are called barriers to communication. See, I'll discuss some barriers over here so that when you communicate, you can overpower, you can keep these things in control to communicate well, because communication is life. I like to start from language barrier. Language. Yeah, one more thing is there. When it comes to communication, communication is not only speaking a language. Communication includes listening, speaking, reading and writing. Listening, speaking, reading and writing. If there is any problem on any part which stops, which impedes your communication, that would be called barrier to communication. Let's start from language barrier. Language, when two persons, they come together, one speaks in a language which is not understood by the listener, language barrier. If one of them uses an accent which is not understood by the second, language barrier. If one uses language in grammatically, language barrier. Okay, next, organizational barriers. See, in each organization, there are some rules, there is a system of communication. See, sometimes it happens that a person at the lowest rank can't talk to the CEO. So, I mean, if he gives that information to his senior, and his senior will be giving that information to the next person, up to the CEO, reaching, means by the time it reaches to the CEO, the true meaning, the true sense of that information could be lost. So sometimes organizational barriers, they also come as barriers to communication. Next, physical barriers. Physical barriers means, physical here means our surroundings. Sometimes we are in a blocked room, in a blocked cabin, as I say. And we want to communicate with somebody sitting next to us in the next cabin. We can't do that because there is some physical barrier. Sometimes we are in a blocked room, locked room, and we want to convey something. No, we can't communicate well. Sometimes we are speaking something and there is a noise outside. We can't communicate well. Sometimes we are giving lecture in a room which is very humid. I'm not saying it occupies 70 people. Actually, it's meant for 20 people. So it would come under physical barriers. We can't communicate well in the situation too. Next is psychological barriers. Whether we are optimist, pessimist, our values, extrovert, introvert, all these things. Suppose when you talk to somebody who is introvert, he'll not cooperate with you as much as an extrovert does. Okay, they are called psychological barriers. Next is overloaded information. Sometimes due to lack of time, you want to communicate with the help of few words. We put so much information in few words that sometimes leads to barriers to communication. Next, pre-evaluation and message. Sometimes, just by few words, we guess that the speaker is going to say all these things. We don't go through a complete paragraph, complete article. Just by few lines, we guess the meaning. That could lead to barriers to communication. Next, distrust, fear and threat. If you have got fear, if you have got threat from the, you can say no, from the words or from the personality of the speaker, you can never communicate well with that person. These things, fear, threat, distrust, unless there is trust, there is credibility, there will be no communication. Next, cultural barriers. Cultural means whatever comes to us through society. Language is a part of society. Each society has its own vocabulary, own language, rather I say. See, for example, if there are so many words like that, I'll take this example first. There are so many words, when you talk about Hindi language, you have got words like bhabi, which is not in English language. So if somebody from India speaks bhabi, that will not be understood by a person who comes from England. This is called cultural barriers. So language and culture, they are interrelated. Next thing, in the same context, if we go to Gulf countries, see over there people to wish they kiss hands. And if same thing is done in India, people will take it differently. That would lead to miscommunication. Okay, next, incompatibility between verbal and non-verbal means. Sometimes when we speak, let's take an example. I say, I'll give you four ideas, but I'm indicating two. I have just raised two fingers. So my body is not in harmony with my message. If this kind of difference is there, that could lead to barriers to communication, lack of training. We want people to be good at communication. Communication is a skill. One needs to have some deep training in this area. Without that training, without knowing how to speak, how to listen, how to write, we can never expect people to be good at communication. Next, lack of planning. You go somewhere to deliver a lecture, you don't know how to start, you don't know what kind of audience you will be facing too. You haven't come with any planning, that's why chances are many to miscommunicate, chances are many a miscommunication. Next is emotional. Sometimes when you are angry, when you are extremely happy, when you are sad, you can't communicate well. You can't speak well, you can't listen well. Next is physiological. Physiological means related to our body. Sometimes when we are hard of hearing, we'll have to speak loudly. If somebody is hard of hearing, we'll have to speak aloud, he may not listen us well. So that would also lead to miscommunication. Okay, when one can't see clearly, hard of hearing, those things are there. Gender barriers. See, even gender, sex plays an important role in communication. Ladies, they are very emotional. When they come in contact with people, they love to ask questions. They love to discuss those matters which are based on emotions. And when it comes to men, they love to talk about factual things. A lady per day speaks 25,000 words and a man speaks around 7,000 words. So even this thing plays an important part in communication. Hope all these barriers, they are very much clear to you. And next time whenever you communicate, please give some attention to these barriers so that you can communicate well and make your life happy. Thank you.